This is the BBC Third Programme. We begin broadcasting in the Third this evening with another recital in the series recorded for us by Geraint Jones on historic organs in Holland, West Germany and Austria. He recorded two programmes on the organ of the Johanneskirche Lüneburg, and this is the second of them. As usual, Mr. Jones describes the instrument and introduces the music.
The Johanneskirche Lüneburg is a fine example of the lofty brick Gothic style of North German church architecture. Its massive tower dominates one end of Lüneburg, just as that of St. Michael's Church, where Bach was a choir boy, does the other. By the middle of the 16th century, the whole of this part of Germany was Lutheran, and a great wave of organ construction was about to begin. As the influence of Holland was predominant in this area, it comes as no surprise to find that the organ built in the Johanneskirche in 1551-52 was the work of father and son Hendrik and Nicholas Niehoff from Sertogenbosch. Of their instrument, the case and some of the pipework are still in use. The specification was characteristic of its time, a Hauptwerk, or great organ, with its main chorus of narrow-scaled pipes and some wide-scaled flutes and reeds, a Rückpositiv, that is, a positive organ placed behind the player's back, with a secondary chorus for contrast with the Hauptwerk, some more elaborate flute combinations and reed stops of the Regal family, and an Oberwerk, so-called because its pipes were placed in a chest above the Hauptwerk. Dutch organs at this time had very limited pedal departments, and Niehoff provided only a row of pull-downs with 8, 2, and 1-foot stops for this Lüneburg organ. It was only to be expected that a quarter of a century later, Dirk Heuer had been called in to add 16-foot tone to the pedal. The very splendid case, which springs from the two galleries on the west wall, was completed between 1712 and 14, when Matthias Dropper added towers of pedal pipes on either side of the Niehoff organ. The instrument was restored in 1959 by Rudolf von Beckerath, and as it now stands, is one of the finest surviving organs of the North German school, both to play and to listen to, and indeed to look at. To open the programme, here's a set of variations written jointly by the famous 16th century Netherlands composer Zweling and his German pupil Samuel Scheidt. The theme is a popular Spanish dance tune of the time, the Paduana Hispanica. Now, two chorale preludes by Buxtehude, who occupies much the same position in relation to North German organ music as Pachelbel does for South Germany. We have spent so many evenings with Southern instruments in this series that it comes as a shock to find that Buxtehude has had to wait until this final program for inclusion. The first prelude I'm playing is a beautiful setting of what we know as the Passion Chorale from its frequent use by Bach in the St. Matthew Passion. Here it is, Buxtehude's prelude on Ach, Herr, mich armen Sünder. The second Buxtehude prelude is on the Advent hymn Nun komm der Heiden Heiland. Those listeners who know Bach's elaborate setting from the 18 preludes will notice how Buxtehude ends this piece with a coda anticipating that used by Bach. That was Buxtehude's prelude on the chorale Nun komm der Heidenheiland. Some of you will be able to recall the thrilling effect of the Herzogenburg organ in Bach's Toccata and Fugue in F, which I played in the first of these recitals. I'm ending this, the last of these recitals, with another great work, in which I am conscious of another remarkable marriage of music and instrument. Here is Bach's Prelude and Fugue in E-flat.
Thank you.
The St. Anne Prelude and Fugue of Bach, the Prelude and Fugue in E-flat, ends this recital by Geraint Jones on the organ of the Johanneskirche Lüneburg, recorded in collaboration with North German Radio. And that's the end of this current series of Historic European Organs, 12 recitals by Geraint Jones on organs in Holland, West Germany and Austria. The series was produced by Stephen Plaistow.